your people, your situation.
Hey, y'all get up, man. Hey, Stutter Box on, man. Get on up now. Turn the TV on. Where my food at?
Hey, stop playing. Stutter Box finna come on.
No, that's real.
I got two special guests from Mobile, Alabama, Spank Lee and Lil Nardy. But I'm going to tell them who they is and everything before I get into the segment.
What's happening, man? It's your boy Lil Nardy, a.k.a. Nardy Marley, the Rolling Stone, Big Papa Smoke, Young Sounds, and all that shit, man. You
hear me? Yeah, man. It's your dog Spank Lee, man, a.k.a. Julie, Taffree Lee, all that.
Well, you know, today they bring me to the top of the music, you know. I listen to y'all music, and I listen to other people's music, too. But the trends that I see y'all doing, other people doing, is very different. I want y'all to tell me, you know what I'm saying, what do you think music has changed along the lines and everything?
I feel like it's something for everybody. So, you know what I'm saying? I mean, whatever just in the mainstream, I guess they say it changed. You know what I'm saying? But there's always some shit for anybody. You know what I'm saying? So, did it really change?
Yeah, because like the rap game today, like it's so many different forms of rap. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You got the quote-unquote mumble rap. You got the lyrics. You got the trap rap. You know what I'm saying? So, it's all about finding your lane, you know what I'm saying?
Living what y'all saying, y'all rhymes and everything. How does it make y'all feel when y'all see other artists rapping about something they never did before? And y'all like, man, I know this dude ain't finna get signed for what I did. And I know he just didn't sign a deal. And I'm seeing him doing this 5 or 6 years. But you got artists out here.
I mean,
just don't be doing what they say they be doing.
I see the shit every day, but you know, I don't speak on it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is.
Man, this shit rapping, man.
It is what it is, man. So, shit. Whatever. I don't hate on no nigga that bump into a situation, you know what I'm saying? That's just his time, you know what I'm saying?
Right. So, it's his time to go ahead and shine and grind and everything. Not about you being an upcoming artist and everything, like what do you find yourself doing with your music like going in the next 2 or 3 years?
In the next 2 or 3 years, you know what I'm saying? We just really just trying to build a fan base between me and him, you know what I'm saying? There's been plenty of like different type of situations, just when the right situations, you feel what I'm saying? So, I just feel like if we just keep doing what we doing and just keep building our fan base, you know what I'm saying? I feel like we can do this shit on our own. 2 or 3 years, man, yeah, we gonna be having a lot more, man. We gonna be doing a lot of shit.
Y'all got the state on lock right now. What about you, Smoke?
Yeah, man, 2 or 3 years, shit. I plan on being a much better position than I am now. Because like you said, man, we just really trying to build that core fan base, you know what I'm saying? Once we get that core fan base in, we can be in control of any situation that come towards us, you know what I'm saying? We ain't just got to settle for anything. We ain't got to be no labor slave, you know what I'm saying?
That's, make your own money independent, man.
Right. Might have me a legit in like 2 or 3 years.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? I got
a
kid, man.
Oh, you're not 4 months. I didn't know that.
I'm 100, you hear me?
look like you
1,000, nigga. Shit.
What's the ups and downs of being an artist and everything, like, for all the pros and cons?
I mean, for all the pros and cons, man, like, you know, with this rap shit today, man, one day you could be here, next day you could be there, man. So it's just all about staying consistent.
The pros is, you know what I'm saying, getting well, seeing your dreams manifest, you know what I'm saying, making goddamn something from then, you know what I mean? The cons is shit, life don't stop, you feel what I'm saying?
Niggas keep got going.
Real life, niggas got all type of shit that happen in between, you know what I'm saying? So that shit don't stop, we just find a balance.
Can you tell a person like that's watching this, you know what I'm saying, a real life event that you had to go through and overcome like to get out the failed situation and be successful at what you're doing now?
Man, shit, I done been through all kind of shit, man, you know what I'm saying? Shit, I lost my mama, my pops that got killed, goddamn, we got all kind of partners who done got killed, we got partners locked up, you feel what I'm saying? We in this situation, you feel what I'm saying? So, we around this shit, so we just really trying to navigate, and you know what I'm saying? I really always say shit, music saved me, because it kept me, even though we dibbled and down and got in trouble on other shit, but it kept me focused on the bigger picture on what I had to do.
Recently in a situation where like I could have just lost everything I worked hard for in the music shit. So it's time like fly right and do the shit, you know what I'm saying?
Me too, so we all got something to come. We can always talk about it like, man, we've been through this, we did it, but we succeeded in the country and everything.
Yeah.
Spank, let me ask you this. By you being a father and you being the man that you is, what motivates you every day to wake up in the morning and say, I gotta do this for my kids and everything?
Shit, I don't want them to be hurt for nothing, you know what I'm saying? I don't want them to struggle or none of that, man. I don't want to work hard so they ain't got to do the shit I did, you know what I'm saying? Make the mistakes I did, you know what I'm saying? That's my motivation, man.
What about you, Lauren?
I mean, shit, I don't have a child, but shit, I mean, like I say, shit, I lost both my parents, so like my little sister really became my child, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. On some guardian type shit, so I understood after all that type of shit was going on, you know what I'm saying? I had to man up and just really like make sure she was straight, make sure all this, you know what I'm saying? And just really focusing in on a bigger picture, bro. You know what I'm saying? You it's like the rap shit, but you still gotta be a man at the end of the day and right, man up right, to your right. responsibility.
I ain't have my dad, but my mama, she did the best she could. Yeah, so sure, I just had, sure. to, I let out the mama. Whatever we go through, I'm gonna take care of, cause I don't want you to struggle. You stay in a two bedroom shack and I'm out here living lavish and I can't take care of you. I don't want that to happen. So my grind is consistent every day. I'm always working. Y'all don't know, but since I moved to Huntsville, people have put me on y'all music. Every song y'all written, it always influenced me to go hard at what I do. So I want to tell y'all thank you for that, man. Now you feel me? I love. As an artist, can you tell people how to get yourself out there as far as networking and marketing and everything like that?
I mean, right now, social media is the way. You know what I'm saying? Instagram, Snapchat, like, that bring a lot of attention to the artists nowadays, man. And just, you know, just staying at it. You know what I'm saying? Keep putting out videos. Keep doing it.
Rich Boy told me this shit a long time ago. He was like, bro, the people gonna be the judge. You feel what I'm saying? People worry about so much other shit. But like, the people gonna be the judge. If you put this shit out and people react to it and it continuously grow, then you probably got something. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. If girls like your music, I know you got something. You feel what I'm saying?
When girls start bobbing their head, you know what time it is.
But if the people don't like it, you know what I'm saying? It just, that shit just might not be for you. You feel what I'm saying? It ain't. Nothing wrong with it. You feel what I'm saying?
This shit ain't for everybody. That's for everybody. It really ain't for everybody. But, I mean, shit, if it's steady growing, shit, why stop?
What's up? Well, I want to thank y'all for having Spank Lee and Nardy Marley from Mobile out of bounds. You know, I got Marley time in the house. When they come through, they come put on the show. Hey, look.
Yeah, man.
Tell everybody how can they find out and everything on social media.
You can find my social media, man, on Twitter, Instagram, everything. At Tax Free Lee.
I'm on X Video. Nah, for real, man. Follow me on Twitter, at Lil Nardy, on Instagram, Snapchat, Nardy Marley.
Before I go, though, Nardy, you said something that caught my attention for you. Look, like you said, if people don't vibe to your stuff, you might as well stop what you're doing and find you another career.
Yeah.
I've been doing this about a year now.
Okay.
And I thought it was going to be a failure.
Hold on. See, you fucked up right now.
I thought it was going to be a failure.
You fucked up right now.
I know I did. I thought I was going to fail. You know why? I ain't never did it before. I always said I want to do something to make me money and grow and be successful with what I want to do. But I'm always telling me, Malcolm, what is success? I said, living up, waking up, nah, that's that could be anything. But if you put something into it, you want to bring it back, come back, do what you got to do, put your all into it, see how it goes. Like you said, I did this show one time, sit it with the buzz. You know, people, now it's growing. I thank God for the dream aspect.
I told you last time, shit, you been doing something for a year. Yeah. Shit, that's good. Yeah. It's been going consistent for a year. So, whole 365.
365.
Yeah, so
what you just said and wanted me to go hard at what I do. But, you know, these boys, they really good role models, man.
Right. Oh, man, Tech 3-3 on the way, too, man. Like, for real. That.
What you got coming up, Noah?
Don't Shoot the Messenger, man. Coming in January, me and Spank got a little project we finna put out.
Yeah, man. A little collab project, man. Y'all know we get on that bitch, man. like the modern-day Pimp and Bun.
Shaq and Cole, they going for the three-peat, you feel me?
Yeah, man, we Lego fan, for
yeah,
real.
Yeah, you know, for real. Like, shout out to L.A. Lonzo.
We back, man. Big baller brain, dude.
3B, baby, hey, we back, man.
Like he said, like game 7, I ain't going home with the feet. That was on Tech. What's the deal
on
you said?
That was on Tech 3-2,
like he said, man. Like game 7, we ain't going home for the feet, man. You feel me? I thank y'all for tuning in, man. Y'all go follow you, boy. No matter what nobody say about these boys, I know them. Everything they do, they have done it. They live up to their fullest, and they real role models. I don't care what nobody say about Spank, Nardy. They real about what
stand
they do,
up
man.
Guys,
man. They stand up, man. You know what I'm saying? For real. But look, y'all stay tuned. I catch y'all next time, man. Stutter by TV, we out.